active constraints somehow are constraints that matter. And actually, we will see when we will deal with linear optimization that finding an optimal solution of a linear optimization problem amounts to finding which constraints are active at the solution. In this video, we will define the concept of active constraints in the general context of optimization. In order to illustrate the concept of active constraints, let's take an example. So here I would like to minimize the function x squared under the constraints that x must lie between minus 10 and 4. So this is the function. The first constraint is represented at minus 10, and the second constraint is represented at 4. The optimal solution of this problem is actually x star equals 0. This is the lowest possible value of the function, and it verifies the two constraints. Now, actually, if we had ignored the constraints, if we had removed the constraint and solved the problem without constraints, well, the solution would have been exactly the same. In this case, we will say that the constraints are not active at the solution. It means that x star is strictly greater than minus 10, so that this constraint is not active, and x star is strictly less than 4. So this constraint is not active either. So we introduce the concept of active constraints as an inequality constraint, which is verified with equality. It's not the case here. And because these two constraints are not active, we actually see that if we had ignored them, we would have obtained the same solution. So let's take another example. So now I want to minimize the same function, x squared, but I require that x is between 1 and 4. So let's plot the function, and let's plot the two constraints. In this case, the optimal solution is equal to 1. And we can verify that x star is equal to 1, and x star is strictly less than 4. So in this case, the constraint x greater or equal to 1 is an active constraint, while the other constraint, x less or equal to 4, is an inactive constraint. And because there is a constraint which is active at the solution, this constraint matters. Ignoring it would modify the solution. While if we ignore the inactive constraint, that is x star less or equal to 4, then the solution will not change. So the generic definition of an active constraint is the following. Consider a function g of mapping Rn to R, which characterizes one constraint. And this constraint is an inequality constraint. So it's written g of x less or equal to 0. We will say that this constraint is active at x star if it is verified as an inequality at x star. By extension, we will call an equality constraint active if it is verified. Indeed, an equality constraint is by definition always verified with equality. So this is just to extend the concept of active constraints, but it's actually meaningful only in the context of inequality constraints. So what is the impact on optimization? So let's consider an optimization problem involving only inequality constraints, and I assume here that I have p inequality constraints. And we denote by x star a local optimum of this problem. So let's identify what constraints are active and which ones are not active at the solution. I define the set A of x star here as the set of indices from 1 to p corresponding to active constraints. Now, the fact is that we can replace the original optimization problem by a problem where all the constraints are equality constraints, but only for the constraints that are active at the solution. And we can ignore all the inequality constraints that are not active at the solution. So this is a very interesting property because it helps to simplify a lot the problem. Well, but it requires to have some information about the solution. We need to know the set of active constraints at the solution. By using some method, we are able to do so, then we can simplify significantly the optimization problem. In this video, we have seen that active constraints are constraints which are verified with equality. So a constraint is active at X if somehow X is on the constraint, on the boundary. And we have also seen that if we happen to know which constraints are active at the solution of an optimization problem, we can actually drop all the inactive constraints and replace the active constraints by equality constraints to get a problem which will have the same optimal solution.